Hello,
hi.
That's a nice smile, Rama. How are you, Rama Sudi?
I'm good.
Nice to meet you.
Me too.
Okay, in short, you were studying at our college.
Absolutely.
The professional tour guide school.
Yeah.
What was your experience there?
It was a little bit hard because when I started, I was young.
Yeah, very young.
I remember that I cried like a week.
Yeah.
I just want to go home because it was too much for me.
That's a good one.
Mm-hmm.
I couldn't let you go home.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I couldn't do that. Yeah.
Yeah.
Whoa,
so
amazing.
Yeah. I'm just happy that I made it.
You made it.
Yeah.
You really made it big because here you joined a company which was of your dream or something.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Which company is that?
It's Acelia Camps and Lodges.
Acelia Camps and Lodges.
Yes.
I would love to work at Acelia Camps and Lodges.
Really?
Yeah.
You're most welcome.
Wow. Okay.
Yeah.
Another challenge I'm thinking. You graduated as a professional tour guide.
Yes.
We were expecting some challenges of being a female guide.
Mm-hmm.
And you joined a big company like that Acelia Camps and Lodges.
Yeah.
You had huge responsibilities there.
Mm-hmm.
What was it when you first joined the camp?
My plan was to be a guide, but there was a little bit challenge from where I started. They wanted the person that who is more experienced.
Okay.
And I was just fresh from college.
Yeah.
So they told
me... You didn't have a single experience.
But... They just give me a chance, like, mm-hmm. you can wait, just be a waiter for a couple of years, and then if you want to be a guy, then you can be.
Right.
It was nice. I started as a waiter, but there was a little bit challenges in the camp, you know.
Yeah, it's not easy.
It's not easy.
I can imagine.
Yeah.
For a girl like you.
Absolutely not
easy.
Wow. So when I arrived at the camp, it was like 5 women and 50-something men.
Men. That's a huge market, isn't
of
it?
Course.
Oh, that's a huge market.
Yeah,
how could you be able to survive in that, being a female, a young girl,
mm-hmm.
how could you be able to survive in such kind of men-oriented environment?
First, you have to understand yourself.
Yes.
Why are you there?
Okay.
You're not there for men.
Yeah. You
You're
are there
for
work. Absolutely.
Yeah. Okay. And you have to remember how hard it was to reach where you are.
Okay.
Then you can overcome all those.
All right.
Yes.
All right. Again, I would expect some kind of protection from the management.
Yeah.
Some kind of mentoring from the people for girls like you.
Yeah.
Was there anything like that?
Yeah, there was. I met a girl there. She was also a waiter, but she was more experienced.
Okay.
So she was like a sister to me.
All right.
Yeah, and she was like, Rahma, you have to work. These things are there.
Wow.
You have to work first, and then others will come next.
Wow.
Okay.
Yeah, what's amazing? I know you have a lot to tell us.
Yeah.
What's so amazing? You ended up in the different department.
Mm-hmm.
Totally, I was shocked. I was shocked in the first place. Like, what's happening to this girl? Is she going to manage?
Mm-hmm.
And tell me about your new department and how it went.
It was nice and challenge and amazing experience that. Start from getting out from the waiter to be a masseur.
Okay.
But Acelia give me a chance.
Okay.
Like, you can grow up anywhere you wanna be. You can be. You can be a manager. You can be a you can be a guide. You can be anyone you wanna be.
That's a good policy.
Yes.
I could imagine.
Yes.
Yeah.
So they give me a chance. If you wanna be this one, you can be.
Wow.
And then they took me from Serengeti to Zanzibar for my training.
Zanzibar.
Yes.
Wow.
That was a very big experience.
Ndio ulipoharibikia uswahili wote ukaniletea uswahili ambao hata sikutarajia. Anyway, fine. Yeah.
Yeah, and then it was a nice experience and exposure being out from the bush.
So basically in Zanzibar you were like undergoing some training?
Yes.
Okay.
For like a
So to do massage you have to do training?
Absolutely, because you have to know a human body. There are other part of a human body you are not allowed to touch. Maybe you can just make a discomfort for somebody.
Okay, okay.
Yeah, so there are
then
the muscles.
Then you discomfort for yourself too.
Yeah, yeah, so you get in trouble.
Okay.
Yeah, so you have to know where to touch exactly. The
and
muscles,
how to touch.
The how, yes.
My goodness.
Yes, and the pressure and everything you have to learn from there. So other people, they can say, I want a medium pressure. You have to know which medium pressure am I.
Oh, there are, yes, medium pressure.
Yeah, and hard pressure.
And hard pressure.
Light pressure. So you have to control,
goodness,
your hands.
Oh my goodness, that sounds really professional.
It is.
Wow.
You have to work hard and to remember all those training that.
Yes, 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 yes.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. So
I'm so happy for you, Rahma. Maybe you can promise me a massage before you go back to. Yes, you do that?
Yeah.
Oh, amazing. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
I wish you all the best, yeah?
Thank you.
Really, from the bottom of my heart, I'm so proud of your representation. Other girls will learn a lot from you.
Thank you.
Other female guides, students, and whoever.
Thank you.
You are such a shining star.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Thank you for having this interview with us.
Thank you so much.
Next time, Karibu sana.
Asante.
Wow.